The history of comics is almost as old as human culture, in fact, older than history. Because history actually started not until someone had written or described the then historic events. But before letters and writing, there were pictures. And pictures in sequences, either to describe a successful hunting or to ask the gods for their support in a future hunting, or as a decoration of a special cave where the young ones were initiated into adult members of the tribe, or. Of course, we will never know about the ultimate purpose of these cave comics in Lascaux in France or Altamira in Spain, or in a dozen other places. Maybe they were created just for fun. Skipping fast forward. Fun is not the most used word for early Christian art, I guess, because the depicted stories from the Bible were more torture porn than anything else.
Okay, I said this obviously for the sake of pure provocation. Even though I'm really not religious at all, I like medieval art and I like to go to the museum and look at this just for the for the beauty it sometimes contains and the time machine qualities of it. And without wanting to be condescending at all, it has this naive these naive qualities, this simple honesty, especially when you look at the way how the artist here tries to create space on the panel.
But these early EC horror, no fun allowed comics were right in the center of the medieval culture, decorating doors, ceilings, windows, shrines, altars, translating the stories from the Bible to the illiterate folks. They had an important function, and correspondingly precious and expensive they were made. And these comics are still one of the first cultural achievements that come to our mind when we think of medieval times. Even though they were pretty rare at the times, or because they were rare, they were estimated highly and were taken care of, and so could survive until now. One of the most important relics of the medieval age has no religious connotation, but is a comic as well. A huge one. No exaggeration to say it's big time oversized. The Tapestry of Bayeux was made around 1080, very probably in England, maybe in Canterbury. It's just 53 centimeters high, but 69 meters long. Most probably designed by just one person, the embroidering itself had to be the work of many, most probably female embroiderers. It tells the events after the death of King Edward of England in 1066, who had no children. So there were three candidates for the throne. One of them was William, Duke of the Normandy. He invaded England and conquered it after beating his rival Harold in the Battle of Hastings, hence becoming known as William the Conqueror.
This is really a Golden Age comic, Iron Age comic, don't know. But it's a message in a bottle from former times, and we know a lot about how they build their boats and weaponry, etc. And it's all accompanied by a sub-narration in the frame, which comments on the main plot that is told here in the middle stripe. And it has obviously this combination of text and pictures, as you all are familiar with, and it's so not so uncomic-y. In this book here, the word comic, I haven't read that. Instead, they used the metaphor, it's a silent movie with subtitles. Okay, if you want to say so, for me it's a comic. So, and again, sometimes you have very direct commentary on the main plot and what these people in the center may have in their minds. We have a slow but very effective action build up here. There's the other side. This is King Edward, obviously. And we have a decent body count, and the dead stay dead, or stood dead. I like how these arms are attached to the body here. And one very famous detail I will show you and then end this video with it is this one where all these dudes are pointing at above here. Ist die Mirante Stella a shooting star? And this is the first depiction of a shooting star in art history. So, I could show you the whole reproduction of the Tapestry of Bayeux, but maybe when you're in France, there's a museum. I wasn't there yet, but when I'm there, I'm certainly will look, take a look at this historic comic. So, thanks for listening and watching to my version of The Bold and the Pretentious. Goodbye.